Yeah, right. Here you go. This is one of those big TV units. The ones that are now obsolete and everybody's tossing them out. So I thought I'd do something to it and show you what can be done with it. You know, you used to put the old TV in there and you cut the back out of it. So the arse of the TV tube goes through. But you know, these are all over the streets here and seems like such a waste. Well, in fact, this is number 73 for me. And we're going to turn it into a low boy. Very simple. Just take a quick look at how I do it. See if you can't make some use out of one for yourself. Let's turn it into perhaps a $500 unit. First, remove your doors. Looking over there, there might be a view top window in as well. I've taken a measurement, the height of the top here. What we do is we chop it off here and bring the lid down, put it on top here. The wind here, though, so we take a measurement of this here, which is the recess of 40 mm. So it's not right. This lid here will be the one they suppose, 20 mm. And we want that to sit with enough clearance, a bit equal on the bottom. So just a guesstimation, we'll make it about there to land. So the 20 mil coming down from the base, simply going to hit there about right. So we'll take the 40 mil, which is the thickness, and there we are. Magic line's already there. And then basically mark your line, the measurement from the platform base from there all the way around. So currently it's 46 and a half, and we go all the way around. Bring your camera over to have a look. Go all the way around, and oh, that's what cheap the lenses, you can't see jacking. As you can see, there's a line all the way around. Same on the back. Well, there's a join there, and I'll peel that off. So we have to cut one across there, two across there, again three across there, four across there, and we'll take the top off. So behold, let's see it done, eh? You'll need a handsaw, nice handsaw or a circular saw, probably both. So pair of safety glasses. Never start any tool without a pair on. You end up with severe eye problems. No. I was ignorant of this. Okay, so we're just going to line it up and chop it through. Very simple. Jack, support the center. grip, because as we cut, pressure will clamp down on the blade. Closer look at that one. You can see it's very simple. We cut this one here, number one, it's separated. Again, this one over here also is cut. So now that we're going to cut these ones, we put the clamp here to stop the pressure of the top pushing down the blade jam. So I'll whack you there. How do we get it there? The saw will go, we'll use that. If not, we'll cut it higher and then shorten it later. So, we'll start from this side. I won't go that low, so we'll just... One, two. Like so, and we'll make the cut meet somehow so we can separate the top at least. There we go. So when we got a cut here, now we can quickly just either take that off or cut it. It's not important. This is all just the leftovers. I will just rip it straight across here. Invisible man pulled the plug out. Separate. Right, we're back here. Sorry about the dodgy view, yeah? So, now you can see it's cut all the way around. We've missed a little bit smidgen there, but that'll be okay. You can just get your little handsaw or run it through with the circular sort of joining up, and there she goes, she's separated. So, I'll just run that through. See it. I'm going to remove the top. Place it here. Especially here, reusing the top, we'll put a bit of carpet down there. So when we put the top upside down on there, it's not going to get damaged and scratched from whatever surface you have there. It's not of good quality. So, release the jack. There might be a couple of little bits and pieces that are stuck, but mostly it's off. Nope. pause it, but I might get a splinter. You remove the top. Lean down like that. Move the camera up here so you perhaps get a better view of what I'm doing actually. I'm going to show you. As I said, this is number 72 or 73, and alright, I'll get you. Alright, you can sort of get a picture there. The first thing I do is take the boot, take it to there, knock her off. Maybe have a pair of pliers, as I said. Yeah, I'm as hot as it's probably about 30 degrees today. And yeah, just pull them those machine sort of nail pins out, wherever they are. Careful not to damage too much of your show piece, which is the top and your edges. And the rear don't really matter, you're not going to see it. So again, just remove them all. If you can, if you can't, just cut them off and whatever, belt them out of the way. Now I'll give you a clear image of how I do it. Grab it, lever it. Don't go this way because you'll wreck your top edge. Whatever. The weld's geared up for appearance these days, so. removed all them. Over there. You gotta just give it a bit of that there, give it a bit of a clean. Just clean up this bit of excess glue. There it was. First cut, which is a rough cut. Once the rough cut's done, and come around and zero in on the raw height, which is already up there. Bird's eye view then. So generally, now having to bring it back to the same level, well, you're just making it the same height all the way around, very simple. So, use the line if you can, sort of thing. There's no real set rules how you do it, but you'll do another. World is forever running out of resources. Not that I honestly truly give a damn. To me, it's all going to end anyway. But it don't matter how it comes off, as long as it does. Room for room there. Just move this way. Back over here into the space. Now I'll just do this and see what I'm doing. Yeah. Get yourself a nice handsaw. Pretty straight. For the nails. to a month away. One for me. It all depends which way you use it. Have a nice modern day blower. The work area is a bit of a probably good to add a few more wires so you can trip over and stuff. Makes you feel like you're actually doing something important. Up.